Pick a card, play your hunch. If you're right, you'll win a bunch on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Hello there. Thank you. Nice to have you here. Hi there. Welcome to Card Sharks. Thank you very much for coming down to join us. You're delightful. Thank you. That's a terrific opening poem. I like that poem, and our thanks go to Clara Strickland in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Thank you, Clara, for sending in that poem. We crowned a new champion this time, ran out last time. We're going to bring him up here right now, and he's going to go for the big money with the money cards. Let's bring up our champion, Mike Roach. Hello, Mike. Why don't you remind our friends about yourself?
Okay, I'm Mike Roach. I'm from Torrance. I've been living out there about 2 years. I'm an airline pilot. I'm single. And I jog, play tennis, and racquetball.
Ooh, said the girls, a single airline pilot. That's nice. Are you ready?
I am ready, yes.
And let's open the board and let's go for the big money. Let's get to the money cards. Come on, Mike. All right, Michael, you know how we do it.
Great.
You won $200 in the game. Now, that's yours to keep. We won't take that away from you. Right now, we've got a brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut, and we're going to give you new money to play with. This time, you're going to bet that money. Starting on the bottom line, $200 in these three cards. When you move to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money and three more cards. Your minimum bets are $50 till you get to the top card, that big bet, and there you must bet at least half the money. Mike, we really want to give it to you, so come on. Here's $200.
Okay,
yes,
I really want
it too. You really
want
That's good. That's the only way to feel.
I'll take all of it.
As in the game, we start you off with a choice of two base cards, Mike. First, a five. Okay, do you want that five?
Yes, I'll take that five. I'll bet $200, and I'll go higher.
Right away, the whole thing.
You bet.
$200. We're rooting for you.
That's right.
$200. Higher than a five? Oh, no, it's a two. Ooh, well, you're not out of it because we're going to move that two up. But, of course, that big bet, it cost you the play of these two cards. However, the two moves up here where we give you the other $200 of betting money. Mike, you've still got four cards to go. Now you've got a great card.
Good card to start with there. I'll go all of it higher.
If you had said less than $200 on the two, I would have thought $200 higher than a two. And it is with a five. Okay. Mike, you've got $400 down with a five.
Still in good shape. I'll bet $300 and higher.
A little more conservative on the five this time. $300 higher than a five. And it is with a queen.
All right.
$700 and a queen, Mike.
I'll bet... not your money. I'll go $500. It's lower.
$500. Bet lower than a queen.
Yes.
All right. You're up over that magic four figures. Mike, we're going to move that nine up now. Now, you must bet at least $600. You can bet more. You have $1,200 and a nine. What's your big bet?
Kind of an iffy card there. I'll bet $600. It's lower.
All right, going to go with a half. $600 lower than a nine. And it is with a two. $1,800, Mike. That's not bad. Good comeback, Mr. Busted. Come on down here. That's terrific. Started badly and came back strong.
I did.
With the $200 in the game, that is an even $2,000 for that play on Card Sharks. Not bad at all.
Not bad at all. I'll go for more.
He's going to try when we meet a new challenger right after this commercial message. Ready to defend the title?
I am.
All right.
Ready.
Let's open up the board and get to the cards then. Janice and Ann will start loading in the cards with two brand new decks of cards as we meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Robin Braisman. Hi, Robin. Nice to see you. That's a nice firm handshake for a lady.
Thank you.
Why don't you tell us about yourself?
Well, my name is Robin Braisman, and I'm a third-generation Californian. Been here forever, lived in Pasadena, and I've just moved to a new apartment in L.A.
Good. And I've got to furnish it?
Yeah.
That's kind of tough, huh?
I have no couch.
Well, maybe you can win a couch here today.
Sure.
Good luck in the match, Robin.
Thank you.
To both of you. Each player has a deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go in the air. Mike, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Robin, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. But before you can begin to call high-low on the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question. Mike, we start with a question to the champion, and that's you. We asked 100 married men. Since you've been married, have you fallen in love with a woman other than your wife? How many married men said yes they had?
I'm single, but I'm still a male. It's got to be a high number. Happens to me all the time. Let's go 62.
62 married men have fallen in love with another woman since they've been married, Robin. Higher or lower?
I don't think quite that many. I think it's a little lower.
Say lower. Well, if it is lower, you'll go to the board first, Robin. If not, it'll be Mike. The actual number of married men who've fallen in love with a woman other than their wife is 5. Very much lower. Robin, wow. See that? Robin, we'll take a look at your base card. You start with a 5. Now, you won the question. Whenever you do, you have the right to change it.
I'd like to change it, please.
Next card off the top of the deck. You must play this one. A 2. Great change.
The card's going to be higher.
Higher than a 2? Oh, no, it's another 2. It's not higher. That's a surprise. And that gives Mike a chance to play a 7. Now, you didn't win the question. You can't change it, Mike.
I'll go higher than that.
Higher than a 7. No, another 2. Neither player could advance. Anne will fill in the spaces. We go to the next question to you, Robin. We asked 100 married women. Remember the last question? Since you've been married, have you fallen in love with a man other than your husband? How many married women said they had?
I don't think married women look around quite so much, so I'm going to say it's kind of low. 35.
35. Okay, Mike, higher or lower?
Well, I don't agree with the reasoning. I think I learned from the last one, so I'm going to say lower.
You say lower than that.
Yes.
They don't look. It was 5 with the men, but you say the women don't look around as much, so you only said 35, huh?
Right.
Okay. The actual number of married women who've fallen in love with a man other than their husband is 18. It's lower.
All right.
18.
Let's go.
However, do you realize, though, that that's 3 times as many women have fallen in love with another? Can we finish this show quick? I got to get home. Mike, you have the right to change that.
I'll change that card, please.
And it becomes a queen.
All right. Going lower now.
Lower than a queen? No, and again, the cards fail him, and it's higher. Robin, that gives you a chance to play off the deuce.
I'll play the 2 and go higher.
Higher than a 2. Yes, this time we've got a card of 7.
I'm going to freeze.
We move over the freeze bar. We can't take that card away from you as we fill in the space for Mike. You've got a 1-card lead, Robin. Mike, we polled 100 women executives. Now, these are all women who are vice presidents of corporations. We asked them, did you start your career as a secretary? How many women executives did start their career as a secretary?
I would think the women that are in that position now probably did start off in that as a position as a secretary. I'll say 57.
57 started as secretaries, Robin.
I think it's higher.
Even more. The actual number of women executives who started their career as a secretary is 48. It's not higher. Mike, you got it.
Good card to start with, too. I'll go lower.
Going to keep the queen and go lower than the queen. And again. Mike, those cards don't like
you.
You're winning the questions, but not the cards. Robin, you have to play the 7. Call this.
It's going to be higher.
Higher than a 7?
Yeah.
No, it's lower. But you're protected with that freeze bar, so we don't go back any further than that. Robin, and this is interesting because as we fill in the spaces, Mike needs 4 cards, Robin needs 3. We're at sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Robin, we asked 100 people in Southern California. If you had to give up one, would you rather give up the automobile or indoor plumbing? How many people said they would give up indoor plumbing?
Oh, well, I think that even as a modern convenience, it's also a modern necessity. I think maybe 15.
15. Would rather give up indoor plumbing than the automobile, Mike.
Californians are attached to their cars, but it's got to be lower.
Even lower than that?
Yes.
The actual number of people who love the great outdoors and would rather give up indoor plumbing is 55, not lower, Robin. They'd rather travel those long trips than the short trips. Robin, it is sudden death. You need 3 cards. Mike, you need 4. Your decision, Robin. Do you want to play it or pass it?
I'm going to pass it.
You're going to pass it. Mike, that means you've got to turn them all over to win the first game of the match. One mistake. Robin wins. You've got a queen. Call this.
I'm going to do it. That's going to be lower.
Lower than a queen. And this time you got past that first card with a 10.
Cards are talking to me now. It's going to be lower.
Lower than a 10. No, again they fail with a queen, and Robin wins the first game of the match and $100. Game number one and the challenger will set up for game number two coming up right after this commercial message. And the challenger leads 1-0. We'll set up for game number two with the same two decks of cards. And I say this often, but it's true. If you can remember what's been played, it helps you. Mike, we left off. The question goes to you, and you need this game to tie. We asked 100 United States congressmen in Washington, D.C., if your party nominated a qualified woman for president, would you support her? How many congressmen said they would refuse to support a qualified woman for president?
Let's see. Congressmen would just about have to come out on record as stating they would support her. So a low number, I'm going to say seven.
Seven would not support a woman for president, Robin.
I think it's higher. I think it's higher.
Higher than that. You think the male chauvinism would prevail there?
Definitely.
Yeah, sounds like a Greek chorus out there with the women. The actual number of congressmen who would refuse to support a qualified woman for president is 58. It's higher, Robin. Fortunately, we take confidential polls because it'd be a lot of congressmen in trouble otherwise. Robin, your base card is a 10. Do you want it?
I would love to change that, please.
And it becomes an 8. Ooh, not a good change. Got to play that one.
Higher.
It's 50-50. Sure. You say higher than an 8, and you're right with a king.
I'm going to say the next card's lower.
Lower than a king. Yes, with a 10.
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze. Needing just two cards to become the new champion. Robin, we asked 100 married women. Have you ever gotten so mad at your husband that you starched his underpants? How many women said they had starched their husband's underpants?
I don't think most women own starch anymore. They may not wash them. I would say maybe 20.
20.
Yeah.
What do you think, Mike?
That's cruel and unusual punishment. Lower than that.
Lower.
For sure.
The actual number of married women who have gotten so angry at their husband that they starched his underpants is 2. It's lower, Mike.
Yeah. It couldn't be that bad.
I think if I were the husband of one of those two ladies, I would be very careful what I said and did. Mike, your base card is a 9. Do you want it?
I'll change that.
And you can change it to a jack. Good change.
Pretty good card. I'll go lower on the next card.
Lower than a jack. Yes,
all right,
with an 8.
All right. I'm going to have to freeze there.
Don't want to play that 8. Mike needs 3 cards. Robin needs 2. The question number 3 to you, Mike. We asked 100 pediatricians across the country. Should teachers be allowed to spank children who misbehave in school? How many children's doctors said teachers should be allowed to spank children?
I think that's becoming more the vogue now, to discipline. I'll say 53.
53 pediatricians said yes, teachers should be allowed to spank children.
I don't think that pediatricians would condone that quite so much as parents might, so I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower. The actual number of pediatricians who said teachers should be allowed to spank children who misbehave in school is 57, not lower, Mike.
I want to change that card immediately.
Don't even want to wait till I get over here to change the
faster.
8 to a 9. Little better.
I'll go lower than that, playing the odds.
Lower than a 9. Oh, no, a big haste. Came up at the wrong time. That gives Robin a chance to play off the 10 and call this.
I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower than a 10. Yes, with a 9.
I'm going to freeze.
And you'll freeze. Robin needs 1 card. Mike needs 3 as we fill in the space. And again, we're at sudden death. Robin. We asked 100 people, do you think most advertising claims are truthful? How many people said yes?
I don't. I don't think they're truthful, so I'm going to say it's 20.
20 people said advertising claims are truthful, Mike.
I believe a few of the ones I see. I say higher.
Higher than that. The actual number of gullible people who will believe anything and think most advertising claims are truthful is 16. It's not higher, Robin. You've got that all-important control. And we have a very interesting board, Robin. You need 1 card to win. Mike needs 3. You've got control. Do you want to play it for 1 or force him to play it for 3?
Oh, gosh. I'm going to pass it.
You're going to pass it. Mike, you must play the nine. You have to turn them all over to tie it up. One mistake, we have a new champion. Call this card.
Tough card to start with. I'll say lower.
Lower than a nine. Two, very much lower. Right.
They're making up for the last game. This card, it's got to be higher now.
Higher than a two.
Hark.
Yes, with a four. One to go.
By the skin of my teeth. Higher. Higher for the
higher
game.
Higher than a four to tie up the match. He did it. Three cards. Well, let's set up for the tiebreaker.
Live and learn.
What, Robin?
I said live and learn.
You live and learn? You had a difficult decision because you didn't know what your one card was going to be. I think he made the right decision. He just finally got the cards falling for him. Tiebreaker with just three cards up there, three questions here. Someone's going to play the money cards. Mike, we asked 100 women in a previous studio audience. Would you rather spend an evening with Woody Allen or Sylvester Stallone? How many women said they'd rather spend the evening with Woody Allen?
Humor over sex, I'm not sure. I'd say a low number. 23.
23 would rather be with Woody Allen than Sylvester Stallone.
I think they'd rather spend it with Woody, so I'm going to say it's higher.
Higher than that. The actual number of women who love a good joke and would rather spend an evening with Woody Allen than Sylvester Stallone is 34. It's higher, Robin. And here's that all-important base card in the tiebreaker, a big ace.
I am going to keep it and say it's lower.
Lower than an ace with a king.
The next card's got to be
if
lower.
If this is lower, we have a new champion on Card Sharks. We do. Congratulations, Robin. Good win.
Thank you.
Mike. That's nice, and you're leaving here with $2,100. That's not bad.
Very nice. Thank you.
Thank you for being here, Mike. Robin, come on down here. What?
I've never won anything in my whole life, ever.
Really?
Really.
That's terrific. I hope she's going to win a lot more with the money cards coming up right after this commercial break. And our audience encouraging our champion, Robin Braslin. Robin, are you ready?
Oh, yes.
Let's get to the money cards. Come on up. And once again, the $200 is yours. We're going to deal out a whole brand new deck of cards, all shuffled and cut. Janice will deal them out with three cards on the bottom level. Smile, Janice. You're on Candid. Whatever. Okay, three more cards on the second level. We add another $200. And, of course, the big decision, that big bet where you must bet at least half the money. $50 minimum bets. Let's do it, Robin. We're rooting for you. Here's $200.
Thank you.
And your first base card is an eight.
Ooh, oh, I want to change it.
Don't want that. Let's see if we can improve it. And we did with a four.
Good.
Okay, $200 and a four, Robin.
I'm going to bet $200 that it's higher.
Right away, the whole thing. $200 higher than a four. It is with an eight.
I'm going to be a little more conservative. 100 that it is higher.
Higher. No face card showing. $100 higher than an eight. Now we got a face card and $500.
I'm going to bet $250 that it's lower.
$50.
$250.
$250. Half of it, $250 lower than a jack. And it is with a 10. Up to $750. The 10 moves up. We add the other $200 of betting money. Robin, you're going good. You've got $950 and four cards to go.
I'm going to go $500, that it's lower.
$500 on a 10. Lower than a 10 for $500. It is a 7. Now, $1,450 with a 7, Robin.
$200, that is higher.
Let's see an ace now. $200 higher than a 7. No, it's a 2. But that's not a bad trade because you've got $1,250 and a deuce, Robin.
I'm going to do the whole thing. It's higher.
You're going to double it or you'll have nothing. Higher than a 2. Yeah, with an 8. $2,500. But a tough card moves up for that big bet. Robin, you must bet at least $1,250. You could bet more. You've got $2,500 and an 8.
I'm a wreck. I'm going to bet half that it's higher.
Just one face card showing. The odds are on your side. Half of it. $1,250 higher than an 8. And it's a 10 for $3,750. Never won anything, huh? pay the rent.
Oh, God, yes. For the next 6 months.
Ah, she needed that one. That's great. 39.50, and we'll be right back with a new challenger after this. We are very happy for our champion, Robin Braslin, who's won $39.50. So is the whole audience. I hope you are, too. And you'll join us again tomorrow when she defends her title on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive Leonard Silver's five-piece tea and coffee set in heavy silver plate. Includes tray, coffee and teapot, sugar and creamer, all furnished by the Leonard Silver Manufacturing Company. And some of our contestants will receive from Gallery of Homes a book on home improvements. Gallery of Homes brokers, if you're selling or buying a home, you'll find they do their homework. And La Machine, the complete food preparation system from France. It's like having a chef at your side. La Machine by Molinex. And Eureka's new ESP Extra Suction Power Vacuum. 50% more power, more beating, brushing and cleaning action. Six-way height adjustment Eureka. And Quizel Lighting, your choice of one of these brass finished table lamps with bronze highlighting. Complements traditional and contemporary settings. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.